Welcome to the Jay and Friends Podcast.
I know, boy. I know, boy.
Yo.
Yeah, we good.
Yeah. Yo, but Chama and these other little fool sites, yo, on the gram, yo, they make a motherfucker.
Sam, I feel like
fat. Like, I gain weight
just looking at my feed sometimes. Like, yo, God.
I'm ready for the weekend to go eat.
Yo. All them DC spots all in the air. You get to see the whole DC and all this shit.
Man, I got to go down there in a couple weeks, man. We're going to do like the Cherry Blossom tour. We do it every couple years.
Oh, yeah, check that out.
Yeah, I'm going to go down there and do that, man. So I'm excited because I'm going to get out there and eat some food, too.
I did the Bygone Brunch with my mom and my girl. That was the first time doing the brunch there. I did dinner there for Jimmy's birthday last year. But yeah, we did the brunch. Brunch was chill.
Yeah, brunch was chill. I've been in there once. Did you walk out on the deck?
Yeah.
I'm terrified. You know I'm terrified of heights. So I got out there, bitch, got the shaking board, took me aside.
Oh, no, that's I always try to look in the hotel, see if I can catch somebody cutting over that motherfucker.
Only you.
God. Yo. I know I would. I'd be trying to put on the show like, hey, boy.
And we're back.
Listen, we are back. The whole crew to Baltimore. Guess boys are in the building. Glock Boy Tay is here. Mm-hmm. Nell is here.
Your favorite guy.
Everybody's looking good, smelling. It's just money in here. The Merrimack right there.
That's a mortgage payment. it's a big mortgage payment right there.
Nah. That right
my
there.
My mate's voice. Yeezy. That right there. Man.
These look fly, but those are money.
Yes.
You was not talking like that just 2 minutes ago.
And that's a good, I should have put some Air Max on. Good shout out for Air Max.
Yeah.
This is Air Max month.
Air Max month, yeah.
Yeah, man. Y'all ready to open this thing up, though?
Let's go.
Let's go.
All right, fuck it. It's college basketball season. Let's get it.
Hey.
Dress it up and make it real for me.
Best Future song ever made.
Yes. Did you see this at the Rolling Loud? Oh, my God. They went bananas.
Whatever that fucking man.
Turn them radios up.
There's something I'm starved for. Spend a day to get my mind blown. Dress it up and go to Nassau. 200 miles on a dash. Got a rubber pound up a dash. Put your names in the Grand Rapids.
Welcome to the Jay and Friends Podcast. Introducing Dookie D.
We're ballin' like the Marsh Madness. All these cops shootin' a nigga tragic. I don't wanna live in lavish. Like I'm playing for the Mavericks. I don't want for the bitch that might have made me fuck her even though she average. Dirty money in the cook. 45 by my good. We young nigga in the cook. Take you out for some drugs. It's counter smoking, no rush. I'm on the one way flushing. Loud pack smelling mustard. These fucking police can't touch me. These bogus police can't touch me. These fucking niggas can't touch me. Apply the pressure with the VVS. I drive the phone like it was a ship. Drive the phone like it was a ship.
I don't know how this song I'm about to play even made it to the radio. Now it's 2023, but fuck it.
Ooh, yeah, motherfucker. That's that shit.
It definitely was on.
The boys are back.
Thugs, make it hot, make it pop. Oochie Wally Wally, Oochie
Bang Bang. Your favorite parties are here. Turn them radios up, turn me down, let's go.
In the living room, getting it on, and they ain't leaving till 6 in the morning. Oh, it's for Oochie. Oh, you ain't know how many O's in the bankroll. Sorta like the game show, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? But my name ain't Regis. Nah, it's the one they call when they want their thing beat up. Honeys for bodies, feet, Bravehearts, guns in the party. Waves, braids, baldies, trademarks, the army. Is that horse? It must be. I heard he husky. Yeah, there go jungle, eyes red, looking for trouble. And that's Nas dancing with dimes, but who his man is? The end is here, thugs.
So I already know I have a flip for this. Let's go. R&B daddy on the ones and twos. Tip your bartenders and your favorite strippers. Let's go.
It's a whole lot of chicks in the living room getting it on. They ain't leaving till 6.
I'm going to tell y'all how I was a fanboy last week at this concert.
They been
twerking, it ain't working. I've been curving cause I'm focused on you. I'm trying to get you back to each other. Trying to be a man if you let me. Baby girl, you so thick and you look so sweet. I just wanna taste your peanut butter jelly while I'm feeling on your body, yaddy, yaddy. Oh, your body, yaddy, yaddy. While I'm feeling on your body, yaddy, yaddy. Oh, you wally, wally, wally. You looking dangerous. I want you when it's obvious. We could be making crazy love. Whole world gonna be hating us. Cause I'm feeling on your body.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the JFP episode 170. We are here. We are back. The full crew is here.
Yes.
Ooh.
How y'all boys doing? How you feeling? How was your week? You had PTO for 2 weeks.
PTO 2 weeks, yeah, man. Geez.
You can't limping like you wanted a third.
almost. But no, man, my time off was great. My first week I had to spend it off with working. Did some things, got a chance to go up Philly for Freeway's 20-year anniversary of his album. Saw State Property, got to see the Jada came out, did the freestyle. So that was love. And then last Friday, I got to see one of my favorite Wu members, but my favorite Wu album, Liquid Swords, got to see the Jizzer. So that shit was great. So I lost my mind.
Yes, sir.
Man, well, I can't compete with that. Y'all boys out here living. Now, it's been a slow motion week, man. But I like it that way. I like it. You know what I mean? So,
all right. So we recorded early last week because Eric Bellinger, I was on the last one that I played, came and I went solo or whatever. And it was this chick named Go Go Monroe. Go download her. Her EP is in your phones. Little young girl. She could sing her ass off. Boy, I forgot the boy named Jackson. He was Jackson. I think he wanted a son to them, but he killed it. He had the chicks all, you know, going crazy. And then Eric Bellinger came out and just smashed it. And I was just I was conversating with the ladies and, you know, cutting jokes and shit, drinking good. And it was down at the harbor in DC, Union Sound.
Okay.
So it's when you come in, it looked like a little club, and then you go down like two flights of stairs, and then it's like under.
Yeah.
It was a nice little, I like small venues like that. So yeah, it was a good week, and ready to pod out.
Yeah. I definitely miss you guys. Yeah. Definitely miss you guys.
Yeah, you will miss me, friend. Fucking right. Yeah. Listen, when it is two people, dog, we get out of here. They was like, damn, I still got the rest of my night left.
Yeah, it was early. I watched like two videos.
Yeah. Time goes forward this weekend. Y'all like that? I hate it.
I'm excited. Because
by the time we record next week, the sun gonna be out.
Yeah, it'll just be going. I'm excited, man. I like longer days. So like, yes. I know spring coming around, summer coming around, days get longer. I start to get more active, you know, just because of that. But
shorts come out.
Oh yeah, I got a little thought daddy pack ready.
We gonna stop using that term.
Early too, because I'm like I got some shorts hoodie combos.
Yeah, you ready? Yeah, you ready?
When
are we gonna get these $500 Kif shorts, though?
Yeah,
soon, because I now with those threes, I'm working on something because I'm trying to find me a leather top because they came out with a leather. They, hell yeah, they did the leather because they did the leather top. Yeah. But they did the leather top for the new colors that they dropped: the green, the burgundy. I seen Jim Jones on them. I said, wait a minute,
is Jim Jones in his nail? You gonna be sweating, my boy?
That's cool. I'm with it all.
Better get it in before it get too hot, my boy.
I'm with it all.
All right, let's get it. The army is bringing back the BL. You can be. They resurrecting that army marketing. Let's get it. This shit goes back to, I remember Be All You Can Be when Living Color was on TV. So what was that? Mid-90s, early 90s?
Early 90s.
They said that shit still what came out, 81? I was born in fucking 82.
Born 81,
Wow, that's crazy. Yeah, so.
Listen, army, this is not sneakers. Retro commercials and retro slogans. This ain't gonna help you make your end goal. I remember it was a skit on Living Color. It was like, you remember the Be All You Can Be song? But they remixed it. It was like, be all that you can be with an ugly wife and a messed up life in the army.
But I, so, I think that adds to the character of the song, right? It's like, it was one of those things that stuck with you, and it's a, like a part of the culture. You know what I mean? Like, right, you be like, man, you better go be all you could be. You know what I'm saying? Like, whoever people saying that to, regardless.
I mean, because they ran it for 20 years.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
So yes, you tell the Afro singer, like, aim high, nigga.
Yeah.
That's one.
It might it might resonate, man. It might. I mean, I don't think it's going to boost the recruiting, but I don't think people really give a fuck about what the slogan says.
Facts.
But, you know, I could dig some of them retro commercials.
Because what is this, Generation Z or whatever? They were talking about, yeah, they wearing mullets and the mustaches. That's fine, but they don't want to go on the service, dog.
Ain't going to war for you, boy.
Oh, real quick. So the last episode, we talked about healthy shitting, right? Tara Boynton, who is our medical expert and our staff Negro counter, she said, by medical terms, healthy, you know, we shit 3 times a day.
Yeah.
She said, healthy shitting is 3 times a week. I said, ain't no way.
What?
Ain't no way.
3 times a week?
Ain't no way. Week.
No, you're going to get blisters on your lip and some more.
Hey, no, man. The toxins about your body.
Yeah.
Shit, nah, man. So, yeah, I don't know why I had that popped in my head. But
Three times a week?
Yeah, no.
No, you ain't had nothing to eat, did you?
No.
All right, story time with J-Man. So here it is, Monday in the year of our Lord, 2023. March, like 5 p.m. in the afternoon. So I pulled a Tessie out and I'm washing it. And, you know, I got the power wash, the pressure wash. I got all my tools to detail my car. Mm. But I had ran errands before. And when I left out, I had my gun. And I was, I had some like sweatpants on, Nike pants and a hoodie. So when I came home, I'm like, all right, I ain't going to change my clothes. I'm just going to change the shoes.
Your weapon.
No, I changed my shoes. I left my gun on me.
No, your gun, your weapon.
Yeah, I got my gun on me.
Okay.
I didn't come upstairs. I just went in there and put on some beaters to wash the car. So I'm almost done. Some dude in a Dodge Dart coming down the street, and he slams on the brake. So like, all right, maybe he like, you know, because this is a dead end right here. So I'm like, all right, maybe a few weeks. Like, he's maybe about a U-turn. Dude hops out the car and starts fast walking towards me. So now at this point, you know where my Tesla parked.
Yeah.
So it's pulled out. So I go on the other side, and then I just draw on him. Mm-hmm. He's like, whoa, 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 whoa. I was like, dog, you walking up on me like you about to do something.
Yeah.
He was like, no, I was just hoping you was here because I just got off the phone with the bank, and I'm about to buy a Tesla, too. I was like, well, don't walk up on me.
That is not the way. That is not the way.
He was like, I'm your neighbor. I was like, dog.
No, you're not my neighbor.
I was like, if you're not right directly in front of me or to the left and right, I don't know you.
Mm-mm. We live in the we live in the same neighborhood.
I almost shot my boy. He was
stopped him in his tracks.
Yeah. He was speed walking. So he was like, nah. All right, dog.
You was ready.
That's to be more careful.
Jay was ready.
Yeah.
And then the crazy part, that was Monday. Wednesday, Donnie, shout out to Donnie. He showed me a page where dude was just, he was either taking out trash or doing something in his garage. Yo, two kids ran up on him and stole his tried to steal his car. They don't even take it, but they tried to steal his car. I was like, yo.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. Uh-huh. I mean, Shorty had the stick and everything in there.
Yeah.
Did you see it? You saw
I saw it, yeah.
I don't know, yo. I'd have been quite nervous. Like, yo, I'm going to get these little guys because he...
I think he gave it to him, but they misplaced the keys.
He said, let me get my keys. Let me get my keys.
And he walked off. Like, he walked away.
And then they went in the car and was looking through it. And I think they left with a bag. They didn't leave with the truck, though.
Mm.
But, yeah. I don't know. Pop.
That's a fit. My wife just talked about that because she leaves out early. She's like, man, when I open the garage up, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'll be like, what's going on? What's out there waiting for me?
So I would tell, and this is what I do. I don't open the garage until I'm in the car.
That's what I told
her. And I'm ready to go. Hit the button. It be open.
Yeah.
And now we leave out. And as soon as I see my car clear, I'm hitting the button. I'm going to watch it close. And then I'm out.
Like, yeah. That's what I told her. She was like, oh, that makes sense. I'm like, yeah, nigga. Like,
I did it because I didn't want to be cold. Because you know, you open the garage. Normally you open it up and you're like, woo, Jack. Yeah.
She'd be ready to go. You know what I mean? She get the car and gets it moving. You know, me, I open the garage up. I start the truck in the garage, open the garage up.
Walking outside.
I normally got my gun in my hand. Yeah. Okay, let's go. You know what I mean? Like, my gun don't be my hand.
Yeah, my man Doc, him and his wife, they about to get their HQLs in there, Curry, Wayne Curry.
And his wife was like, yeah, because I want to shoot somebody. Like, oh, no. Shit, no.
Like, tell her call
like,
me, yeah.
We told you, he's like, no, you don't want to shoot.
That's the last thing you want to do. Shoot
nobody.
Yeah, yeah, you better throw that motherfucking gun at them, bro.
Overwhelming amount of U.S. veterans say they can't make ends meet in this economy. More than 80% are having financial issues. 64% are saying they have difficulty making ends meet in the past year. Go.
I mean, that's what we've been talking about, what? I mean, from the end of the year to this year. They're not paying them. I mean.
So I'm a
man, them Hellcat payments high, brother. You know what I'm saying? So the deployments ain't kicking in.
The key word in this, and this is how I look at it, it said veteran. So a veteran, I looked at it as somebody who has served their time.
Okay.
Now, right? So I'm going to play devil's advocate. I advocate for higher pay. But here's how I'm going to be different. I don't think that they utilize the resources and everything that's meant for them to use before they get out. Whether you do 4 years, 20 years, I was a victim of that shit too at one point. You get so used to being paid on the 1st and 15th mm-hmm. that nothing else matters. I'm comfortable, I'm good, and whether I go to work or not, I'm going to get paid. So it then, you know, and I was like that for a few years to the mentors, like, yo, fuck getting promoted, go to school, and start doing these other things. And then I did. And then as I was with people in my same field, when they leave, like, send me a resume. By the time I got out, it's like I took all of they shit and then combined it. But I had somebody to kind of tell me that. But if you're not preparing for the end, that shit is it's an eye-opener. Because you're getting BAH, basic allowance for housing, BAS, basic allowance for substance for food, and then you're getting your pay and you're not paying medical. Mm-hmm. Now you get out, you don't get BAH, you don't get BAS, and then you're getting 50% of your base pay as your retirement. Yo, so let's just say a guy's an E7, that's probably like $2,300 a month. That don't make a dent in shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, maybe your house note. And, you know, and then I don't know if the Navy and the rest of them do it, but the Army, they call it a drop. When you get to, like, I think year 15, you could borrow against your retirement.
Oh, wow.
So basically, you get a lump sum payment. And then if you have to do over 20 and you get I think it's 2% per year, right? So if you took the drop and only stopped at 20, your retirement would be 40% of your base pay. You got to continue to do the time to get it back.
Pay it off.
Yeah. And I know dudes who's taking that drop.
Oh, wow.
But the dudes that I know took it, used it to invest in houses and other things. And,
yeah, so
and
really
they went on to, like, they were going to do over 20 years. Yeah.
You got a plan.
But a lot of dudes don't have a plan, man. And that's really the point I was going to drive on.
Now that you pointed out veterans, and I'm going to take it a step further because now I'm not including retirees. So I'm looking at veterans as somebody that did 8 years, got out, decided it was going to do something else with their life. I talked about this before, and I always said when you go in the military, think about the job you're going to have when you get out. And with that being said, a lot of people go in there and they pick jobs that doesn't translate well to the civilian workforce.
You look cool on the video, though.
Yeah,
did they teach you that, though? Like,
I don't fucking teach you that.
Yo, bro, they sit you down and then if you don't, you have the opportunity to say no, but a lot of people feel like they're pressured because they 9 times out of 10, you want to leave right then. So they'll tell you what you qualify for, and then in the recruiting office, they'll tell you what you qualify for, and they're going to show you some fancy-ass video that don't you show you shit about what your regular job life is. It just show you, like, the highs.
Yeah.
Show you, like, the Super Bowl. Don't show practice. And don't show,
workouts,
nothing. So when they get in there, and they be like, okay, well, yeah, you got Black Hawk Mechanic. You got, I'm going to do a Navy one. You got undesignated, and you got, I don't know, give me another low-level cook.
Yeah, a cook.
Yeah. And so he'd be like, shit. And in the Army, they'd be like, yo, you could be an executive-level chef if you go.
Right.
And that's like the tier of the tier because you're going to go work at the White House or for the president. Like, but dog, that's not like.
That's not really reality, you know, for a lot of them. So they get in there and they choose these jobs and the recruiter put them in jobs that they don't know shit about.
Facts.
My recruiter didn't know anything about my job. He was like, I don't know what your job does. Maybe I tried to find somebody that knows. Thankfully, I had family in that job. But yeah, you're picking jobs, you're getting out too soon and you don't have a plan. They don't prepare you to get out. They send you to a little course, a 1-day course. They teach you about resume writing, how to tie a tie, how to, you know, like they, stupid shit like
and
that.
And that 1-day course, they think, and the Army is a week, but even still, that resume be trash and they be thinking, like, I'm ready to go to the world.
Right. Like, no, you took your uniform off for a day and came in and teach this class. Yeah. You ain't slick, Slim. You know what I mean? So they don't prepare veterans to get out. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, that might attribute to some of this, you know, having difficulties financially because they're not preparing them to get jobs.
Yeah.
They letting them leave the service without getting the schools that they need, you know, preparing them that way. So yeah, they gonna struggle.
Yeah, right? I wonder why, like, when military get out, like, why I know some of them go to like being COs and stuff like that. Why don't they go to like being police?
No. That's the universal thing. Cause you qualify with a weapon. And you got military time, so you could bypass a lot of the stuff that a normal person got to go through to join the force. So that's what they do. But again, in the Army, somebody who was an ammo NCO, all they do is just haul bullets and keep count of them. Or somebody who was a cook, or somebody who was a
drove trucks, cannabis,
drove trucks, like dog, like.
Oh no, I've got a couple Army guys in there, and it's funny because like the two Army guys that I have came in there, like they be wanting to work hard as shit, like so they got like two jobs, like yo, you need anything else? Because they trying to get that OT, it's like they trying to get this paper, so they trying to move as quickly as possible to get this done to either go to the next job, or they like yo, you got anything else? Because they want to get that OT, right, like, they be definitely trying to get that paper,
trying to get to that money.
Yes, sir. Omni and the Hellcat was sentenced to 5.5 years in federal prison for his illegal cable company. He'd been fighting this for a minute, but we knew this was coming. It was coming. You know, I was like, we was talking out in the group chat. And he was like, I respect him for getting to the money. I'm like,
that's my guy.
You can't play with the white folks.
My Philly brother.
You can't play with the white folks TV shows, dog. Nah,
he been getting money for a long time. And it really kind of showed how much money he really was getting because, like, yo, he just gave him $30 million.
White collar crimes. We talked about that last week.
Yeah.
Five and a half years.
Trying to hear how many checks, how many cars and stuff he had. I mean, we all know Omni had matter. Hella
take
whips.
Him. Like, take him. Take him. He was like, take him. Take the cars, like that girl had $27 million. She took from the IRS.
Shorty.
She only doing what, four years?
Something slight. Yeah.
And then she had to pay 7.9 in restitution. And they took it like, okay, I'm up when I get out.
Yeah. And he's gonna be up when he get out. Yeah. Like it ain't like they shutting down his business, like his reloaded business. Yeah. Because he said, like, make sure y'all continue to shop. Like,
so reloaded,
I think got 30 days till
reloaded
he gotta turn himself in.
Is sneakers, right? The reloader is the sneakers.
His reloaded merch is everything.
But that's was going against Kai.
Okay. They were cool at one time. Like, so like, they were supposed to do the sneaker thing. That's why he just said, F it. And
now I remember they
start
was
doing
arguing,
it. Like,
they
I'm
going
to do
arguing
it.
And he was like, I know the same dude that make yours. So I'm going to go to him and he going to make mine. Yeah, I got it. Yeah. Nah, man. Yo, hold your head up. Yeah. Do your time.
But he's not going to do all five.
No, he's going to do all five.
That's federal.
That's federal time. He's going to do
it's 90%, right?
He's going to do all that time.
He ain't doing that.
You don't bail out of that.
Let's bet a dollar on it.
Bet it.
Dollar.
Let's go.
Bang.
Three-way bet.
Bang.
Pause. But yeah, that's he's going to do all that time. Yeah,
he paid all that shit up front.
Nah, but it's federal, though.
He paid it.
Feds put you in time in that case, not to let you out of jail early. Yeah. That's one thing you can say about Fed time. You get it. You stand there.
But at least he get to avoid Nike getting in his ass.
Shit, I wouldn't be surprised. Nike going in there. Well, they dealing with Kyle right now, so they on his ass.
See, he get to fly under the radar now. Like, yo, deal with that. I'm locked up. Leave me alone.
Yeah. Both of them sneakers trash as shit.
Yeah.
Chris. I mean, we're going to get the car, right?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, so. Do I got car? I think so. Yeah. All right. Chris Rock, Selective Outrage, special hit Netflix. This is the first time ever the streaming giant did something live. I didn't think they was going to be able to pull it off the way they did. And immediately once it was done, it was available to be viewed. So shout out to Netflix for pulling it off. You got to do something to keep up with Disney and Hulu and the rest of it. Yeah. Y'all bleeding customers, but congratulations. So let's get into Chris Rock's.
Yo, my man waited till he got to Baltimore to drag the holy shit.
Jada.
Out of Jada. It will.
In your hometown.
In your hometown. Damn, and he talked about Cherry Hill. He talked about Cherry Hill and everything. Like, yeah.
I did my own work.
Yo, I mean, of course, a lot of people don't like his type of comedy. I'm not a big fan of his type of comedy. I'm cool in the movies when he went like Adam Sandler, stuff like that.
Yeah.
But he's not my type of comedy. But I really was laughing. I was laughing at two things. Like, yo, he really saying this shit? Like, so it was funny. And then, yeah, I mean, some of the shit just really was funny. Like,
where's the punchline?
He was going, I mean, hard. That, I mean, talking about the gay stuff. Yeah, I mean, he just was going there. He paying for pussy.
Yeah.
That man, mama was in the crowd eating my pee for pussy. That's it.
Until he got to talking about his daughters and kind of like that whole story about his daughters and getting kicked out of school, until he got to that point, like, I was not entertained. I was just kind of sitting there.
I was falling asleep too.
Yeah, I was just kind
of
sitting there.
No, I was dozing, but it's just, like I said, I was just amazed that he really went hard and said some of the shit that he said.
I was like,
hey, who really said
but
that?
I agree with you. Like, I don't care for Chris Rock type comedy.
Chris Rock is more of a, we think, if you think Dave Chappelle appeal to white people, I think Chris Rock appeals to them more. I think he catered to them.
I see a lot of people was saying that about that. Like, he was catering to them, like, saying, because he said nigga so many times. And
I think he just did that because it was Baltimore and, you know, it's niggas. Sorry. But it was, we was
in
the room.
Yeah, that shouldn't count for my counter, that because that's what people was talking about.
We were in the room, but he also knows how to work a room full of white people and never say that word.
As absolutely.
To Dave don't give a damn.
No.
He don't care if transgender, gay, bi. That's why I think that he is a little bit more, Chris is more white friendly than whatever. But they are both white friendly.
But it's like, when looking at this and now comparing him to Dave Chappelle, where like you saw him trying to borrow some of his like his comedic style, trying to like talk about serious issues and make it in a comedic way.
Shit,
that abortion shit, he tried that shit, and it's just like
he might help write some of it. These guys be this ghostwriting is crazy when it comes
with
to
Dave.
Comedy
Dave motherfucking
shit.
Goat, bro. Ain't nobody writing.
No, I'm saying Dave might have wrote something.
Oh yeah,
for Chris.
I think this is a mix of you know, when you know, like a chick, if she hang around a dude long enough, she'll start to pick up his slang.
Mm. Oh, for
that's
sure.
That's how you know your chick cheating on you, FYI, guys. But I think that he...
Jay just said a Snapple fact. I can't let that one slide. Yeah. They pick up on that slang, son.
She be like, yo, God. Like, what's when you calling me God?
New York nigga you fucking with.
She be like, hey, Mo. Like, you from Alabama.
Yeah,
but nah.
No more brunches.
That stand up was a hybrid between Dave Chappelle and Kevin Hart to me.
Yes,
exactly.
Absolutely.
It looked like he was like, all right, I've been watching y'all boys. Y'all been killing. Mm-hmm. And Kev is recording his. And of course, they was touring. So he's able to see it. And he meshed this together. And I asked somebody who's seen Chris Rock stand up. And they was like, out of what was on Netflix, maybe 55 to 60% of what he'd been touring was in that. And then he added some new stuff and he moved the jokes around. But again, I think that this was a mesh of Kevin Hart, talk about my kids, let me talk about my divorce and cheating and whatever. And then I want to get into
Do we really know about Chris Rock though? Like, he's been that open that we really know about him? Like, we know about
that divorce was big. Yeah.
We know about Kev because Kev is social media crazy and his transgressions with, you know, his wife and stuff like that. So we know about him. We think we know enough about Dave, but do we really know about Chris Rock besides just the movies and stuff that he play in?
Not.
I don't even follow Chris Rock.
So. I don't either.
I don't. Yeah. What's the purpose?
I think he's forever pookie in my eyes, but whatever.
forever.
He even said, I mean, so when he started talking about the whole, you know, him with Will Smith and Jada, like that 10, 15, 12 minutes, like I appreciated that. That was funny to me to hear him talk about
that. You think that was funny?
I enjoyed it.
Okay, so
I enjoyed it.
It was funny, but to me, it didn't sound like a joke. It sounded like I was venting.
I mean, it was like a cringy joke type thing.
It wasn't even cringy. He was just like, Charlamagne called you a bitch. Joe Budden called you a bitch.
Yes,
Drink Champs called you a bitch. Yeah. Bitch. And I'm like,
you slapped me.
Tell me how you feel. Like,
but he admitted to like, nigga, I can't beat you, nigga. You played.
That's Ali. That's a simp. That's a simp. That's a simp player.
I thought it was funny though. I mean
some people just know.
like, yo, I can't beat this guy, yo. Like,
nah, and yes, you steal him. That's still on him. Ain't no rules to fight.
It's zero rules. I don't get paid for this. I don't get paid for that. I get rid of motherfuckers quick. Yo.
How you spell that? That's a name.
I don't know. I don't get paid for that shit. There's no rules in fighting for me. There is absolutely no rules in fighting. Like, yo.
I'm not a boxer.
Craig hit Debo with that brick. Mm-hmm. But nah, man. Overall, it was good. Some people, it was.
I just didn't hear any, because I know he went kind of hard with the abortion, and he went hard with the LGBTQ, the letters. Yeah. He went hard with them, but I didn't hear any like backlash on it because he went kind of hard.
They like Chris Rock. Again, he appeals to them.
Yeah.
So you know, certain people can get that off, and certain people can't, and it is what it is. And of course, you know, Dave Chappelle uncancelable. Cancelable.
At this point, yeah.
Absolutely.
Kev couldn't do that, though. He couldn't do that.
Hell no.
Nah, Kev couldn't do it. I don't think Cat could do it. Nope.
Cat definitely couldn't. Kev make it real funny, though.
Yeah, he'll make it funny, but you
can't. Cat probably can do it, but Cat probably don't give a fuck about being canceled, though, because he's just a thug. Like, yo don't care, so he wouldn't give a shit.
Beat up by 13-year-old.
Yeah, he did. He did. That was a bad time for my guy.
All right. I got one for you. This is a random one. The ugly duckling or the less popular chick that was more successful and beautiful than the chick that got ran through?
I mean, I've seen it. Seen it in high school. See it now. Yeah. Actively. Like, Shorty was...
I'm going to his class reunion this year. So I'm going to sit in the corner.
Y'all going?
I want him to... you're getting a ticket. Yeah. I want Tay to identify...
Where you graduating from, Tay?
Pikesville.
Oh, okay.
So I want him to identify all the ugly ducklings that now are a 7 and higher.
Yeah, I mean, I follow someone online and I'll be like, oh yeah, you turned out all right. And then like the ones that, like, you turned, like, okay, like, that's slick. I'm proud of you. You know what I'm saying? And then I see some of them and I'll be like, damn. Like, I remember like when you had like a class or two older than me, and I'm like, you ain't amount to shit. Straight like that. Like, you didn't amount to shit. Like, all the niggas wanted you and you ain't doing nothing. 3 kids, not to say you... Kids gonna hold you down, but you just looking bad. Your shit ain't going right. Like, damn, son. I've
seen it, cause like back when I was at Lake, the state was taking us over. So my freshman year, 96, we were half a days every Wednesday. So on half a days, you saw a guy and a girl walking down St. Louis Drive. You already know what that mission was on. Like, they would try to make it like they weren't together. So he'll walk in front of her and she follow.
Yikes.
But like, you seen like all the. Yo, it was really grown-ass men going down Lake, because Lake was like the end-all be-all when it came to school. Like, you was going to go to Lake, let in and let out when it came to Lake. Mm-hmm. And everybody, you had the drug dealers pulling up in the freshest whips, temp tags. They was coming through there. Like, yo, these girls are 16 years old, my guy. Mm-hmm. You coming through with a $70,000 GS 430. Yeah. Yo, she got a book bag on, my guy. Like, she can't even wear heels right. Trash. Yeah. And a lot of the ones that was really hot in the ass, like, you see them now, like, yo, you used to really be lit back then. Yeah. 16, 17, 18, like, 19. Then that shit just went down from every social media joint. That shit just went down from Black Planet to fucking Facebook. And like, now you see them now, like, yo, you really trash. And then I've seen some that's would consider the ugly duckling, like, damn, she's just getting bread. Like, she is RN, mm-hmm. traveling nurse, like, really see it, though. Like, seeing it, like,
she's still ugly.
She, like, I mean, because of the bread, she, like, a strong 7 because of the bread.
That's solid, though.
Because of the bread.
Yeah, we did.
You take the bread away.
Ha. Yeah, 4.
Ha.
Dang.
Strong 4.
Dang.
Strong 4, the possible.
I've seen some, I mean, that are sitting probably like a solid, like, I mean, just. As they got older, bodies matured, face matured, mm-hmm. you know, like they just came up.
Yep.
It was just their time. You know what I mean? Or they learned how to do make whatever it might have been, it was their time. And I'm like, I'm cool with saying that. You know what I'm saying? They ain't getting no play and they ain't in a good position. Don't got a whole bunch of kids. Married. Got a stable job. You know what I'm saying? Don't post no stupid shit online. I'd be like, yeah. I'm like, yo, that's what's up. That's what's up.
I've seen the ones that's been ran through, like, you just knew, like, yo, she fucking at a young age.
And yeah.
Young age. And mm-hmm. you just, like, now, like, yo, you 40, 41, and trash.
It's trash.
Trash.
Oh, all right. Has a woman ever broke up with you because you were too nice? come on, come on now.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Yeah, I've had a girl start dealing with me. She was like, look, I can move to any down in any neighborhood, be all right. But then she was from Poplar Grove.
Okay.
And
understandable.
Yeah, yeah. And she was, you know what I'm saying? She was outside. And she was just like, yo, you just too nice.
You
man.
An adult?
I was probably like 19.
Okay.
Yeah. And she was like a year or two older than me. But we was cool though, you know what I'm saying? But like we come through da 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 da. But she was like, yo, I can't fuck with you like that. Like I can't have you come around because this is gonna eat you alive. I'm like, oh shit. I said, I respect that shit. I respect that shit. She was like, yeah, you know, we you know what I'm saying, we can kick it or something, but I can't fuck with you like that. And I was like, okay.
No, I never really had it. Cause like y'all know me. I was just out here outside. No, but I had a chick because I worked too much. It's just I didn't make time. Like if I really felt like making time for, because I had two jobs and I just was like, I could always say after a second job, but I just didn't. And she was like, yo, you work too much for me. I ain't gonna be, it's long ass laundry list. And I'm like, and I just said, oh, all right. And I came my ass to work. Nah,
I had one. She was just like, yo, you know, I don't get mad. I don't scream. I wasn't screaming. And I was like 19, 20. Like, you know,
I was a screamer when I was younger. No, I was a yeller. I ain't even going to hold you. I was a yeller. What the fuck? Like, I was.
She was used to do like beating
not now,
her,
but I
beating
was.
Her and arguing. Oh, I'm like, no, we good. Like, it's all right. I know you got 4 years. Like, no, I was good. I'll come later. It's like, you're not mad? No, I ain't mad. Like, shit happened. And she did the same thing. Like, yo, like, she's from the west side of Jacksonville. And, she's like, oh, you too nice. Like, I feel like I could. She's like, I'm not running over you, but it feels like I can. And I'm like, but you're not. And she's like, well, all right.
Yeah. I was an emotional ass Libra.
I was fucking up friends after that.
Oh, that'll work.
Yeah. J-Bone, huh? Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
You ever been to Jacksonville? No.
No.
That's the biggest, stupid city in the world.
Mm-hmm. No, I've never been.
Biggest landmass city in America. Yeah. It's a hidden gem, boy.
Yeah.
It is a hidden gem.
West Palm Beach.
Mm-mm. Nah, that's right. Oh, go up 70. Go up 95.
Miami.
95.
As soon as you cross over down there, the Florida line, you right there in Jacksonville.
Yes, sir.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. Man. As soon as you cross over there, from Georgia, you right there.
Yeah. All right. Blah 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 blah.
We got a Tampa branch. How's Tampa?
Tampa's lit. Let me know where you want to go.
We have a Tampa branch.
I'm from that area. Yeah,
oh yeah.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah.
We have a Tampa branch.
Check y'all to my hood. Do couples need time apart, and if so, how much? So you got the married guy, long-term relationship, and the single guy. Let's get it.
I don't think so. Like when that's like the new thing. Like we need to take a break. Take a break from what?
No. I mean, okay. So let me put it in the context. Time apart, like just away from each other. Guy time, girls trips.
Yeah. 100%. 100%. I literally will tell Jimmy, like, Jimmy, why the hell you don't call your friend, Joe? Like now, trust me. You got some guys out here don't like hanging with their girlfriends. I fucking love hanging with my girl. My girl is cool. My girl is fun. She loves the music I love, so we can go out and do. But then sometimes I want to be with the homies so I can do hood rat shit with my guys.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Okay. So that's just times like when I want to get out and ride my bike. I want to ride my bike. I want to pop fucking wheelies. I'm 40. I can still wheelie blocks. I want to do that shit. I still want to play the game with my guys. Like, that's my guy time. So, yes, women... And men, like, you need that time apart. Go have girl talk and friends and eat crabs and
but
go
how much
drinks.
Though? How much is healthy?
Healthy, I mean.
A week, let's say a week. How much? A month.
Probably, probably once a month. I don't think you need 2-3, like, your life stressful as shit. if you gotta be around your girls or your fellas that much, I get fella time because we get to pod every week. So this is a part of,
absolutely.
I get to be with my guys. Yeah. And so for me, I get to be hanging with my guys. And then, of course, we setting up the guy trip. And when we have that, it's going to be awesome. We might pod on the road or some shit. Yeah. Bring something.
I ain't packing.
Nah. You got a little bit.
Yeah, we do something. We go to the studio, though.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Well, we're going to get out before then because, you know, my birthday coming up. So I'm going to get everybody else for that shit. We'll step for that. But I agree. I think once or twice a month, man. But it shouldn't be, and that's like on a good month. You know what I mean? But like, you shouldn't have to go out. Like, me and my wife don't have to be apart from each other. But we want to step out and go do something on our own. We can. I think it does create a healthy relationship. We get a little space.
Yeah.
And like, me and my wife work together. So we literally see each other all the time. So I don't know. I'm okay with it though. I mean, I like my wife.
Yeah,
you
that's
know,
what
I love it. So you know, what I'm
like, really have people in relationships yeah, that like, you know I mean? Like don't like their situation and shit like nah, that. Like, tripping. Yo, you don't want to go. I
and,
like
and Rich Flex. My house big enough. If I go downstairs, I don't see it for a while.
Sir,
he said for a while. So she got.
She done got lost. Fuck it, I gotta say this nigga around here somewhere.
I got an intercom with that bitch.
I was just about to say that's that drink line. I gotta hit the intercom and get a drink.
You got elevator?
I'm only talking. No, I don't. Only talking that shit because Jay got a mortgage payment on his feet.
He really do. He probably got all the wires on the soul. You know how they used to be like, he is the wires on. Probably got all the little wires around your shit and everything.
Yeah, chill, dog. All right, that is the next topic, man.
Look at these motherfuckers. See what he's going for now.
Creed, man. Oh, let me answer. I really would say maybe like you know, one day a month. You know, if potting, if I had to go pod or something, like yeah, that would be enough. Like you miss your mate. And also, like, you working, so, you know, you got time apart, but I get it.
Yeah.
Yes, here he go. Yeah. Here he go.
Boy, throw it out there.
What size is MJ?
11.
Oh, that's my size. For
sure. Last sale, $42.90.
I got $42.
All right, now let's go to the next topic, though. $42.90. Let's get it.
Most of it look like somebody paid for that size 11, $6,100.
My nigga.
$160, $190, $180 retail. What
jeez,
I paid.
So was, they warranty yeah. $42.
Yeah. All right, Creed makes $100 million opening weekend.
That's dope.
Shout out to them.
Yeah,
boys.
I hear it's nice. I want to go see it. I tried this weekend, but every time it would like click in my mind, like, oh, try Creed. Everything was sold out. It was really? Just one chair. Like, no.
I said I wanted to see it. I want to go during the weekday when, you know, I want to see. I don't want people, Negroes talking. I want to watch right. the movie. Mm-hmm. So I want it empty. So yeah, I'm going to try to see it during the week.
Yeah. I want to see it when I see it. It might be a thing I watch at home for me. I don't know if I'm going to go to the movie theater
yeah,
and watch
it. Yeah, streaming
in
a month.
So. Yeah. Yeah.
Because
yeah.
the House Party is already on cable. Already.
Is it really?
Yeah. It's on HBO already. I didn't watch it. And I still.
Negative two.
And I still haven't watched it. Yeah.
Negative two.
I could have had the stream on the Joan, you know what I'm saying? A little bootleg. And I didn't watch it then. I was like,
yeah. Nah, I was looking like it was 9:30, like 9:35 was coming on at 10 o'clock. I was like,
it's actually 30.
Nah, I'm going to watch Naked and Afraid. Like, I ain't even. I had no like, and my guy Bron produced it. Now I had no.
Yeah, I can tell.
Nah.
I can tell.
It was that bad.
Yeah,
wow,
it was that bad.
Damn, they yeah. just telling us that whole lot.
Yo, it's crazy that like Sylvester Stallone doesn't own this Rocky, this Creed shit. Like,
but he didn't write it.
So he wrote the first one.
He did.
Yeah.
Oh well, that's about doing business. Yeah. It's about doing the proper business.
Yeah, he didn't, because he wanted to leave it to his kid. He's like, I'm not worried about none of it. I don't want the money. Of course, we know Sly is good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But he like, I wanted to leave this legacy for my kids and my grandkids to eat. That's here. So, have this.
How did you let it slip from me? If you wrote the first one is yours. How did you? Yeah, we got to do some more research.
Yeah, it because it kind of was like on some like buddy handshake, like yeah, this is mine. Oh, no. And like
the studio,
it was no
shit.
Yeah, it was no paperwork done.
And
like
then Rocky blew up,
and then
pow.
Yeah,
no. Mm. Now, since we're talking about money, BET is in talks to sell their majority stake to Tyler Perry. This is a dope move.
What's up?
This is a dope move.
Shout out Tyler Perry.
I mean, he damn near got every show that's on there right now, right?
Viacom owns the smaller portion of it, and you know, the collective of other people own that. BET owns the major, so this would make this technically, well, outside of Puff, the first black owned, you know, like network. And then, unlike Puff, he continues to pump out content, whether that shit trash or not.
Yeah,
he's pumping out content like BET Plus need to be just Tyler Perry Plus, because that's all it is.
That's all it is.
And he, you know, whether you like it or not, you got to respect somebody who is putting pen to pad and plan in motion and shit. Like,
I be laughing. My girl be watching them shows. Yo. I be laughing. It's like it's like some trapped in the closet type shows. This, yo, like the shit is it's hilarious.
Is this safe space?
For sure.
Oh, I be watching that shit too.
You
watch? Oh my
god. Some of that. Yeah, you know what? You did because you was talking to, oh God, what were you talking about?
I be watching.
It was that, some
I be
shit.
Having to turn my head a lot. But like, yeah, you got to turn your head. So I watched it's the one about the cult. There's a cult. Ruthless. I watched Ruthless. And then
it's who the chick that be like bossy. She be Queens, wild. Queen. Yo,
so I had to turn that because she's like a club owner, but she, for male strippers.
Yeah.
So like they be having like the season one, episode one, this dude is just, I mean, like knocking a bricks off somebody's wife.
Yeah.
Big brolicking nigga. He's like, he got the leather straps and shit on. And this nigga just killing that thing.
Yeah.
And then he had to go out the window because the husband come on, whatever. But like,
yeah. I remember once she was, I'm like, yo, what are you in there watching? I'm in the shower, like, yo, what are you in there watching? Because they was getting.
Yeah.
That shit was like Seven West bathroom in there. My man was hammered down. Them cheeks was getting clapped on the joint.
Yeah. So, you know, they're like, it's the, matter of fact, it's the Queen's Men is the male version of P-Valley. So they have the little dance scene, you know, how we watch P-Valley, the girls be dancing. They do it for the, so I just kind of fast forward through that shit. But the plot line is what is good. That's what, you know, make it dope.
Okay.
Tyler Perry be putting out some shit, man. Mm-hmm. It'd be hit or miss, but you could tell if he wrote it and you could tell when he didn't write it.
Mm.
So
I don't watch none of that shit.
You'll be surprised.
No, nah, I'm always watch that shit. So watch that shit before I
watch Zatima. It's about a dude, he gets with this Asian dude. They don't really kind of tell the backstory, but you have to figure it out. And he do insider trading. He lick. So now he up. He bought a duplex.
Yeah.
And he renting one side, and his girl is Fatima. His name is Zay or something, which is called Zatima. And they get together, and then like, it's like old bitches come in, and his friends be fucking bitches in his back. Like, it's just a bunch of shit, but that one is, I think, you could watch with your girl. And it'd be funny because it's like real. Ain't no gay shit in that one. No gay shit in that one. But it's like real shit. And nope. I watched it.
That gay shit be happening. Shit cover my face. You know I want to see that shit. Shit cover my own face. Like, come
Zatima,
on,
Zatima,
bro.
Zatima a good one. You can watch with your girl. And it's funny because you'd be like, yo, what would you do if Jay was in the back and he had the, because the dude was like, he let a baddie move next door. And he gave the realtor the authority to sign for him. Like, yo, you can approve. So he seen it, and then he was like, oh, I can't do this shit. Then she was like, the next day he got a signed lease. So shorty a stripper, and she moving in.
Oh, shit.
And his girl, like, he's like, oh, shit. So his homeboys is thirsty as hell. So one of them finally hook up with her, and he married. She tracked his phone. He's next door. She like, where's Tim, whatever his name is. And he be like, I ain't seen him.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't know he's next door. So they come in the house. She like, yo, let's just get a drink of water. And she's like, his girl's like, girl, come on, let's go outside, let's have some. And then he look, he see old boy butt naked in the in his hot tub with the chick. He be like, no. So you gotta watch it. It's hilarious.
What's the name of it?
Zatima.
I'm gonna see if she watched.
Might try it out.
Might
try it out.
All right, man. Ja Morant. Ja Morant, brother Ja.
Brother Ja.
Brother Ja.
That little ass gun.
Pow.
Show that little ass. Put that little shit away.
Brother Ja, man. What we got for him? Brother Ja. Who wanna start?
I mean, I know everybody is trying to, you know, save him, like Jalen Rose and Paul Pierce. Like, yeah, I used to carry a gun, and Paul was saying he used to carry a gun when he was because he got stabbed in a club twice. And once was over a female.
Yeah, they had that in
the yes. Yes.
You ain't say that in the group chat.
But this Jai, I don't know his background. I know we say he's grew up. I don't care how he grew up. I don't care. You're worth $200 million. You're the face of a franchise. You're one of the superstars of the NBA. Yo, you don't need to be carrying a gun. You don't it's just flat out. That's what your security for. That's what you should have real security for, not your homeboys that'll ruin your life and to bang that thing just cause. And this might have needed to happen for him because it's like just like the situation that happened with Melo with the stop snitching. It kind of needed to happen because he needed to get those guys away from him.
Right.
So it took David Stern to talk to him and sit him down and to be the man that he is now. So hopefully Jai get it and they can move on from the situation.
First off, I don't think he gonna get it. And that me got me a pessimist. I don't think he gonna get it. I think Jai, we know his story. They did ESPN articles and documentaries on him, so you've seen how he grew up. And
with money.
You see where does Ja Morant play?
Memphis.
What city?
Memphis.
The hardest and some of the coldest of the cold. So the thuggiest of the thugs. And now you accepted in that community. They make you feel like you untouchable. You can go on any street, any hood, any block in Memphis, and you know somebody there, or somebody that you know of gonna make that call and be like, you good, or Ja can't be touched. So now you feel
John Wall has shooters here.
No, yeah, of course. But I'm saying this is where he take it a step further. John Wall left it here. When I travel, I'm hooping.
Right.
He's partying, but I'm hooping. He goes to these cities, and instead of like, if you, because he said I was in fear of my life, pulling out a gun on, because I agree with what Shaq said. You were in the club. You have to take your phone. You have to unlock your phone. You have to go find the Instagram app. Then you have to go swipe, go to live. It's going to ask you, are you sure you want to go live? Then you click yes. Then you had to go to your pants and pull this gun out and wave it.
With no shirt on in the club.
Now.
No shirt on.
You had to do all
club.
Of that. If you were, that does not sound like a guy in fear for their life. But again, I go by, if you are in fear for your life and you got it like that, either because you the star of the team, get your security to fly on the team playing with you, or you hire security or fly security everywhere you go. But
no, he got his homeboys with him. Just like when he got in that situation.
You shouldn't be doing that.
When he got in the situation, when Unc, Shannon Sharp, and his dad was going back and forth, and then like people did not pay attention to it. I was telling people, like, yo, when Shannon Sharp went to the end and was going back and forth with T. Morant, two dudes was on the left side of Unc.
I seen it.
And they were sizing him up. If T. Morant would have gave them the nod, they was going to knock Unc head slam off his shoulders because he wouldn't have seen it coming.
No, hold on. First off,
I know Unc on that deer antler spray.
I don't know the whole real name, but that's whoever he is. He was going to bust through that Greg Lawrence shirt.
But Ja definitely has, because they barred those guys from the arena. So like he had those guys, they couldn't come to the arena no more from that situation and from the situation where they said somebody pointed the beam at the Indiana Pacers. Yeah, so they was like, LA, these guys, and they knew that, yo, just like David Stern, Melo talks about it, like, yo, we know who doing what.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, NBA, the feds, they have the feds working on every team. Right. Like, yo, we know everything you do.
He's like the 6'9 of the NBA right now.
Absolutely.
You are in the NFL, it's 53 players on the team plus 10 players on the practice squad. It's like 1,600 some odd players. In the NBA, it's only 15 of y'all. Bruh, I have the resources and the money to track everybody.
Everything.
Yeah. Everybody. Yeah.
Everything you do.
Everything. So, it's now the NFL is kind of hard.
Mm.
But yeah. NBA, oh, hell yeah. I could.
No, they find the stars. That's like when they was messing with, what's your that played for the Cowboys? Throw up the X. When they asked Joe, I was like, yo, is your mother a whore? Like, what?
Dez,
like, is your mother a prostitute? Like, y'all are slapping the dog shit off this man.
Like if Joe Mixon, which I hate to bring that up.
Yeah, I know.
If Joe Mixon was in the NBA, that they would have already knew about what he had going on. Mm-hmm. Like, but again, it's so many of them.
Yeah.
You're only going to really, and an owner is going to invest in, you know, he can put out on the field, but he's a troubled guy. So I'm going to hire. They had it was Freaky Zeke and Dez. They had PIs following them around everywhere they go, plus security. So the NBA is a little bit different, but I think that I said in the group chat, he gonna be playing in Russia. Like you the face of the NBA, dog. Regardless, right. They asked Bam Adebayo, like, you know, LeBron's gonna be retiring 2, 3, or 4 years. Who's gonna be the new face of the NBA? And he said Giannis. No, dog. Ja is.
Mm-hmm.
Ja's the face of the NBA. He's young. He, you know what I'm saying? He's agile. Like, he was smashing somebody.
The shit. I love him. He's definitely my favorite young player.
He's a baller. Mm-hmm. He can go to the street and hoop. He can play in the gym. Like, he's a baller. Yeah. All around game. And he is the face of the NBA, will be the face of the NBA if he don't get kicked out. And, dog, you got to make better choices.
Yep.
And somebody was like, his dad need to stop getting drunk at the games. Like, at the end of the day, you got to think about it. However old Ja Morant is, he is the breadwinner. Right. So his dad can say some shit, but you know, like, when you got that type of money, I hear you, Dad. My boy.
Yeah. It's over
go,
with.
Go to your house. I'm gonna do what I do. Like, you got that because of me. Like, so chill. Yeah.
Job father man used to make money. Then he quit his job, and I mean, that's how much money he had to quit his job and focus on his kids and on Jai to hone their skills. Mm-hmm. So he has money, but now when Jai, like, yo, I had money. Now when Jai signed his contract with $200 million, it's nothing Pop Mom can say to me. Say to yo,
yeah, like. Like,
I fund y'all lives.
That part. Mm-hmm. So, you know, again, hopefully this time away from the game helps him work through whatever he want to work through. And it is, I don't want to see him do bad, and I want to see him become the face of the NBA.
They definitely going to sit his ass down damn near probably to the playoffs if he ain't out indefinitely.
Unless he divests himself of the crowd he hanging with, it's not going to mean nothing.
Yeah.
If he keep hanging with the same crowd, what do you expect? Yeah, you know what I mean?
Abraza, I say only fool do the same thing expecting different results.
Yeah, so, you know.
Especially if he could be one quick thing, especially because they investigating him because, like, bro, he might have took that gun on the plane to Denver. Like, that's a problem. Like, yo, it's a problem, son.
Yeah. It's a federal crime.
So, along with Ja Morant, Nike is standing next to Ja, but I want to talk about how they cut ties with Kyrie Irving. So my opinion is that Nike understands that their flagship basketball athletes, they have none. And Ja was he's a steal. He is your Steph Curry, like Steph Curry's the Under Armour. So if you were to cut ties with him, who the fuck do you have? You already got those Kyrie Ja Morants that's out right now. So what do you have? So you got to, I don't think they want to stand by him. I think they have to stand by him monetarily, because they don't want to look like
they have to. I mean, no one is moving the meter. Yeah, this shoe that Bron has they got some colors. It's chills. It's better than a lot of shoes that he's dropped.
No,
lately.
He's on his way out though.
No, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, so Bron is still the guy, but
if you drop him, who do you have?
You have nobody. You only have Bron and KD back again. I mean, who people forget that Paul George even has a freaking shoe. And I mean, of course, and Giannis, but once again, their shoes don't move the meter. They move the meter as athletes. They move the meter. But as far as shoe sales, they don't move the meter. Kyrie was the guy who moved the meter from high school, college, and pros. People wore shorty shoe. Yeah. It's a great shoe to hoop in.
See, I think the difference here between Ja and Kyrie is, like, when Ja made a mistake, people were like, all right, we're fucking make a mistake. When you talking about ideologies and things like that, religion, I think
he
scope
tweeted
was
a link though.
I get that for
he pull a gun on nobody.
Yeah, but I mean, Ja ain't pull a gun. He just made a bad choice and pulled his gun out.
He beat a kid and pulled a gun.
Yeah,
on
allegedly.
Him.
Allegedly.
It's three incidents, maybe four. But I'm like,
I think the criminal things are a little easier to kind of just. We ain't gonna comment too much on it. We gonna see how things work out, and then we'll comment. But when you tweet out links to, like, you know, a book that's racist or, you know, anti-Semitic and things like that, instantly people, you know what I mean, gonna be like, oh, no, they don't support Jews. This is so you isolating people. So now you're like, nah, we immediately got to cut you off. And I think that's what that's about.
And I understand Nike. Like, yo, since it wasn't egregious to a certain extent, you got to kind of roll with your new guy. Like, yo, this is our guy. This is the new guy. Because he is about to be the face of Nike. So they like, yo.
You cannot afford to have a Kanye situation. You've already probably got 3 or 4 years of Jaws lined up how they work. You can't afford to cut them.
How many phone calls that his agent has taken because of this dumb shit? Like, yo. And I'm sure his agent didn't talk to you like, hey, yo.
I know he done lost some bread.
He probably lost some, like, some smaller sponsorships.
Since we were talking about Joe Mixon, we got two more sports topics that we got here. Running back from Cincinnati Bengals, Joe Mixon, allegedly shot an 11-year-old kid who was in a group playing with Nerf guns outside of his home. Now, Joe Mixon is a running back from the Oklahoma Sooners. He had a troubled past when he came into the league. I think Joe Mixon probably been in the league 5 or 6 years, if that.
Something about that.
He beat a woman in a bar and the video went viral. But never heard nothing of Joe Mixon since then. But this was before he went to the NFL. Now this happened. And then I was watching and listening to radios and shit. And they bringing this shit back up again. And I'm like,
you know, they always got to bring your pass back up. Got to bring your pass. If you have a pass, we got to bring it back up.
Nobody knows the finite details. He could have thought that was a gun. I don't know. But this ain't got nothing to do with what happened 6 years ago, dog. Like, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I put on him, because I'm like, yo, what? He beat a girl in the bar. It's wrong.
Yeah.
But what the heck? This was the relevance to this. Like, you trying to paint this narrative of an angry black man who has violence or whatever the case may be. Like, dog, come on, man.
Tendency for violence. But I don't understand why he shot an 11-year-old kid with a Nerf gun. I mean, my kid got a bunch of Nerf guns, and all those shits are clearly visible.
And they say it was a group. But we don't know if they done shot his car. We don't know if they shot his windows by mistake plan. You know how people get.
They said Nerf gun, but might not be a Nerf gun. It might be one of them guns that look like.
An aerosol, something like that. It could have been.
So, I don't know, man.
Let's take a video.
It's just good that the kid didn't lose his life.
Yeah. So, last one before we get out of here, Lamar Jackson versus the Baltimore Ravens. You are a resident Baltimore Ravens fan and expert. Let's go.
I won't call me an expert. They're gonna let the league figure out what he worth.
Is the relationship, and everybody, my question for you is the relationship severed?
I think it's tarnished.
Tarnished, not severed?
I don't think it's severed. I mean, first off, they're gonna figure out the league gonna dictate what he's worth.
I fucking
and
hate
a lot
that.
Of people have that. Already come out in this final reason story. Like, within 30 minutes, all these teams came out and automatically assumed that we are not interested anymore.
Because I'm going to tell you why. Nobody wants to pony up the Patrick Mahomes, the Deshaun Watson type. Like, this ain't the NBA.
Well, Mahomes' contract isn't fully guaranteed, though. Even Mahomes has a big-ass number because it's $300 million. But
he still got a lot of guaranteed money.
There's a lot of guaranteed money, but it ain't fully guaranteed. But no, he get not. The... With Mahomes' contract, yes, it's $300 million, but it's
$500
million. $500 million. But it's so flexible, though, how they can move money around for the team.
His bonus and salary can be moved.
Everything can be flexible. So he signed the team contract. Yeah. Like, it's $500 million. He'll never see half of that shit.
Even Deshaun Watson came out and was like, I changed my deal to help the team. But again, he want to, like, if Kirk Cousins can get $84 million, but 3 years back? No, listen.
Fully guaranteed. Kirk Cousins getting fully guaranteed contracts year after year, and he does nothing but either they don't make the playoffs or they one and done.
So he would sign a 10, the non-exclusive, it's like $32 million.
32.5.
Listen, if the Jets don't go ahead and get these two first-round draft picks, get him a $150. I would pay him $55 million a year.
You think the Ravens come out with a $150 though? Because they get the first
guarantee is what I'm saying.
Yeah. My thing is I believe before the start of training camp,
I don't think he'll be Raven. I think they're going to. I think Huntley is y'all starter.
I don't want him.
I like Huntley.
He didn't look bad. I think he just needed more time out there.
Me as a Steelers fan, we will win the fucking division.
No.
Yo, we ain't worried about the Bungles.
Cleveland on your ass, Paul.
We ain't worried about them. Deshaun gonna go get a massage and be out the league.
Deshaun is here week one this time. We not 11.
He gonna get a massage and be out the league. We don't care about Amari Cooper. We don't know. Who else played there?
I think the relationship is severed. A lot of people say also Lamar Jackson would have had a deal had he had an agent. An agent would have been like, listen, dog, you need to take this deal.
Yeah,
but he's his own agent.
Hate that shit that they disrespect him. They disrespect that man's mother when it comes to, you need an agent. Yo, if I get into an accident, I don't need a fucking lawyer.
No, because hear me out. They made a good statement. When you have an agent, that's the go-between, right? So the agent gets to hear the fuck shit. Like, he's 27. He has this injury.
Absolutely. You can't sell that to his mother.
Those are the things that you use as leverage, and then your agent ain't telling you all that. He's just telling you the numbers. But as he is negotiating him and his mother, he's hearing all of these things that the team is using as tactics to lower your value.
Right. Absolutely.
So as a player, I'm like, dog, this is how y'all really feel about me. But it's not. It's business.
Yeah.
It's business. So...
As long as you keep it business, that's fine. But
he's young. Can he separate that?
Exactly. Can you separate
that? Can his mom, mom separate
like white
that?
People will sue each other and go to dinner after because they, hey, dog.
You pay for this if you want.
It's business.
Yeah. So
who knows? He might. We don't know who he's consulting. We don't know who's around him.
Even though Miami said they're not in the run front, I got Atlanta and Miami as the top teams. think Atlanta could do something. Mm. I think Atlanta could probably bust a move and make them. They ain't got shit else. So why not invest in your quarterback?
Did you see that thing with, what's the name going to Miami?
Who?
From Tampa. What's his name?
Tom Brady?
Yeah.
Tom Brady said, he tweeted, he said, if you, he said, I just bought a new dog, a kid, something. He was like, if you think I got time to play football again, y'all lost your mind.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Tom, I didn't see Tom that. I just seen a little
mock. Tom said he ain't got time.
Good for TB12
done.
Yeah,
TB12 done.
Yeah.
All right, man. Closing thoughts. What we got?
Go ahead, buddy. You've been gone for 2 weeks. Go ahead, get two in while I look something up.
Ah. No, I really don't even have one, man. I just glad that I'm back. You know, PTO time is over, so back to partying. Missed you guys, missed the fans. Y'all know me. Like, comment, subscribe. Please share.
It costs you nothing and it goes a long way.
My Instagram friends, please share. I'm really in an asshole mood. Like, so I'm going to be on y'all asses again because, pause, if the group isn't being shared, like, yo, share our shit. Or I'm gonna be a little bit more extra than I was on that one because that one was just like warning shots. But other than that, I love you guys, man. Zone 18, man.
Yeah. Shout out to those that wear the uniform, those that wore the uniform, those that wear the uniform in the future. Shout out to those that hand the VA all day. Shout out to United States of Baltimore. Zone 18 and the rest of the DMV. What you got, Tay?
Yeah, I really honestly, I have nothing. I was looking up things. But yeah, like like Nell said, man, just, you know, like, comment, subscribe. Hit that Patreon if you can. If you can't, you know, at least get the free shit and share it, man. Right. So we respect that.
We already rich. It just gets us this nice aesthetics.
Yeah,
good shit.
We want them Mav Hopper mics next.
Yeah.
Mine is trees don't hang out with grass even though they come from the same place. If that went over your head, I don't know what to fucking tell you.
I like that one. Yeah, I like that.
So on that note, man, this is JFP episode 170. I already gave my shout outs. We'll see y'all next week. We're gonna end that bitch like this. Let's go.
Yep.
You know, this just a real nigga shit. Your real nigga story. You know what I'm saying?
This beat is so bad.
Ice like a bunch of narcotics.
There were.
Pull up in a new Rari. Living like John got it. Chopping bricks like karate. Drank a bunch of codeine. Serving to the dope fiends. Blowing money, stay clean. Michael Jackson, Billie Jean. Got a Panamera, Rana, young nigga hit. Got a young bitch pulling up in a VIG. Smoke a lot of kush and I have a lot of sick. Had to beat the grind up, ran up my chick. Bitch a nigga get money, nigga get bad. Roll up, blow up, run it, nigga sell a lot of crack. You can hear the nigga lying, harder, what you want? I can whip a Maserati, pull it up or don't. Hold up. 50,000 on your watch, young nigga splurge. Have a ace spade, bought a sip of out of surge. Keep a young nigga working at a bus of K. I'ma take a phone call, bust a every day.
What?
Ice like a bunch of narcotics.
There were.
Pull up in a new Rari. Living like John got it.
Come on.
Chopping bricks like karate. Drank a bunch of codeine. Serving to the dope fiends.
They smoke.
Blowing money, stay clean.
Free ride.
Michael Jackson, Billie Jean. Whipping up a cake just to go and snatch a spider.
Fighter.
Young nigga play with keys like a typewriter. Yeah, Al Capone, John got it, was a nigga idol. Hard, I would never snitching, I can put it on a bottle. I promise, in a photo, Beamer driving with a rifle. Ooh. Nigga, where you at? Nigga, we gon' pull up on you
right now.
Y'all bitch looking like Janet in the 80s. We was grinding up from a 2 and a baby.
Ooh.
Got the girl dripping wet like a Jerry curl. Got the styrofoam cup in it full of syrup. Send it over from New Mexico and let me work.
Let's work.
I can't get that
except
for a clean shirt.
Sure.
Ice like a bunch of narcotics.
There were.
Pull up in a new Rari. Living like John got it.
Come on.
chopping bricks like karate. Drank a bunch of codeine. Serving to the dope fiends.
They smoke.
Yeah. Blowing money, stay clean.
Free man.
Check me out. Jason, Billy Jean.
Who bad?
Pop a lot of pain pill. About to put rims on my skateboard wheel. Yeah. Beat that pussy up like. Yeah. Two cell phones ringing at the same time. That's your hoe. Calling from two different phones. Tell that bitch leave me the fuck alone. See you fuck around and I fuck along. I got a love-hate relationship with Molly. I'd rather pop a ollie and my dick is a trolley. Boy, I bury you like Holly. The knees don't say I'm blind, cause I don't see nothing wrong with a little bump and grind. Man, I just received the package. Them other niggas taxing, but my pocket's so fat I'm starting to feel contractions. And my cousin went to jail for them chickens, and he already home, and that nigga must be snitching. Cut him off like karate.
Ay, just like a bunch of narcotics.
Yeah.
Pull up in that new Rari. Living like John Gotti. Chopping bricks like karate. Drank a bunch of codeine. Serving to the dope fiend.
They smoke.
Blowing money, stay clean. Michael Jackson, Billie Jean.
Who bad?
Welcome to the Jane Friends Podcast.